This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, Hope and Maine joins us. We have Bleu, Grijalva with us today, and we are doing some batch cooking. So if you're someone that kind of dreads making dinner night after night, if you make things kind of in bulk or in a batch, it'll help you out. What are the two recipes that we're making today?
So today we are roasting some vegetables and then we're incorporating some legumes. We have some quinoa, we have some green lentils, and we also have some black beans just to add an extra crunch and flavor. We'll finish some of those off with a little kale salad as well that we'll massage with some olive oil and some fine sea salt.
Nice. You mentioned the vegetables. Really trying to take us through everything that you've brought along today.
Absolutely. So, you know, brassicas are always great. We have some cauliflower, broccoli. We have my personal favorite, some Brussels sprouts.
Yum.
Some lovely red Russian kale that's been chopped up and is baby size for us. Butternut squash. Mm-hmm. And then working up the glass row there, some black turtle beans. Of course, your garlic, some pumpkin seeds, which we roast again for added crunch and flavor, a little sea salt, a couple different types of lentils, and then in the center, the darker red is the red quinoa, which we'll use with a little cauliflower today. Fingerling potatoes, a little mix of red and white fingerling potatoes. Mm-hmm. And then a couple of our maker products from Hope and Maine. We have La Piccola Toscana tomato sauce, which has a really nice essence of basil in there.
Mm-hmm.
So it helps balance some of the acidity for some of the dishes. We have Good From Grown Original Homemade Deli Salad.
Yum.
That is a product that's made from garbanzo beans, apple cider vinegar, and then it's free from the top 8 allergens. So it's
wow,
very versatile, very user-friendly, and we'll experiment with that today. And lastly, we have the Ocean State Smoked Fish Bluefish today, finished off with a little rosemary that we'll use to accent some of the flavors, a couple sweet potatoes. And then one of my personal favorites up top here is the Bragg's amino acids. We use that in lieu of soy sauce or tamari, helps give flavor once again.
So, nice, yeah. Wow. So very healthy, hearty, and filling dishes though.
Absolutely.
And you're gonna tell us, you know, we make them in bulk and then how we can kind of...
And how we can incorporate to add, you know, a little flavor here on Monday night and maybe spice it up on Tuesday, and maybe make a burrito for lunch on Wednesday.
Awesome,
so, yes.
Sounds good. So we've got you covered for an entire week and we're gonna get things started in just a bit.
Wonderful.
Yeah, back with Bleu in our kitchen today. He's from Hope in Maine, and we're making batch cooking, which we said earlier, you can make this and kind of really spin it into all different dishes that'll last you throughout the entire week. We're talking legumes here.
Legumes. We're starting with some quick and easy legumes.
Mm-hmm.
Batch cooking ideally is best suited for taking one day out of the week, devote a few hours to cooking. So I find that the labor-intensive items, your legumes, your roasted meats perhaps, chicken, you know,
mm-hmm.
pork picnic shoulder, roasted vegetables as well, can be cooked on, say, Sunday, for example.
Yeah, I like cooking on Sundays.
Yeah, it works well. It works well. It also puts you in touch with your food and I think ultimately helps you make better food mm-hmm. selection choices. So
you have a couple things already going.
We do. We have some green lentils. We also have some black turtle beans as well. What we've done is we've simply, with beans, I like to soak beans overnight. I think it helps sort of minimize some of the gas factor there,
uh-huh.
if you will. And then you,
very
you
helpful.
Know, then you, with the lentils, those don't require any overnight soaking per se,
mm-hmm.
But simply 2-to-1 ratio on those. We add 2 cups of water, 1 cup of legume. We'll allow those to boil, and very much like rice, we'll simmer. We'll allow those to simmer until,
mm-hmm.
and I do a taste test, 45 minutes. Sometimes it takes a little longer.
Should they have a little bite to them?
I like a little crunch, al dente.
Okay.
It's very much like your pasta, you know.
Okay,
some people
so personal
like,
preference.
Exactly. And what's nice about this, once you establish your batch items,
mm-hmm.
you can then, with simple inclusion of ingredients, you know, change the flavor factor. So, say
what are we using now?
So right now we are using the Good From Grown, the deli salad there,
okay.
which is made from garbanzo beans, apple
mm-hmm.
cider vinegar. We have that added. In these particular lentils, we have a Piccolo Toscana tomato sauce, which
Yum.
Again has that basil to help minimize some of that acidity there.
Delicious. And all these can, of course, be found at Hope in Maine.
Absolutely.
Which is great. And I know we're going to get into more details. We don't have enough time to touch upon it right now, but we're going to tell you all about it a little later on in the show.
Wonderful.
Back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, Chef Bleu, he is going like a wild man in here. Hope in Maine is a place. This is a great thing for a lot of families, anybody who's home.
Mm-hmm.
Batch cooking is what we're doing, getting stuff prepared for the week, and then you are good to go. Then while you're at work, you don't have to say, what am I making for dinner
tonight?
What
am I making?
Oh,
exactly.
I hate that.
The age-old conundrum there.
Sure.
So we've wrapped wrapped up some roasted vegetables. We finished off our legumes. We have our cauliflower and quinoa. We're going to do some simple plating here.
Sounds good.
We have our kale. We've massaged with olive oil and sea salt. We've added some butternut squash. Our lentils over here in the La Piccola Toscana tomato sauce. Finished off with just, again, some roasted vegetables. We have fingerling potatoes, some cipollini onions, some carrots. Oh. Again, my Brussels sprouts, which are personal favorite. We're just going to top that off with a little bit of shallot and rosemary vinaigrette. I've added a twist of Herbes de Provence here as well, just to get some of that oregano and thyme essence in there. Mm-hmm. But just a little, you know, to your liking.
Sure.
Oh, right on top of the veggies
right on
there.
Type. Man, yeah, just a little splash of that. And then what we'll do is we'll finish
it looks so good.
Kale salad up with a little portobello cap that we've topped off with our good from grown garbanzo bean deli salad. And these cook up nicely. Get the temperature right, forms a nice little crust. We're going to put this hot item right on top of our salad. And it's something you want to, you know, encourage to eat sooner than later because the heat will start to mix with the salad itself.
Oh, okay.
The olive oil and sea salt help balance the sulfur flavor you sometimes find in kale. So it works really well. And it's just a simple step. And then lastly, we have here, if I may, Michaela, excuse me.
Sure. Chef, I already stole a carrot with a little
wonderful.
Lavender. It was so good. I couldn't help myself.
And then simple quinoa, which we cook for just a few minutes. This can either be done in batch form or the day of. I like doing it batch form because, again, it just economizes my time and allows me to mentally, you know, prepare for my meal later that day. And then some cauliflower. And this will, over time, you can mash it. Create a cauliflower mash very simply. But here we go. We have a nice little, little offering of dishes. You can mix this up.
Here.
Add some smoked fish if you'd like.
Sure.
You know, anything. Protein of sorts.
And anybody at this time of year, a lot of people are trying to eat healthy, trying to do better and everything that they have. This is probably the best way to do it. That way you're not grazing and going, oh, I'll just grab this quick.
Absolutely.
It's all done.
Right, right, absolutely. January is the month of resolutions, you know, so I think if you can visit your food from this perspective, it's a little less frightening, you know.
Right,
you start to get to know these ingredients that you may not necessarily have experimented with. And again, Google is a wonderful place to go.
Yes,
it is. Type in quinoa and you'll come up with 27 different recipes, you know, at a minimum.
It's great.
So, yeah, it allows you.
You mentioned eating fresh, also eating local. And Hope in Maine does that because you said you have about 50 vendors in there,
50
right
thriving
now?
Businesses, right, right, exactly, exactly. So Hope in Maine is a nonprofit food hub based in Warren, Rhode Island. We're actually housed in a 100-year-old schoolhouse. We offer three state-of-the-art industrial kitchens upstairs.
Wow.
So we help nurture and guide budding food entrepreneurs through the courses of navigating the food system so they can take a product from concept to, you know, to the marketplace.
This we've actually had a lot of people who've worked in Hope in Maine come here, come on our show. If someone is out there with some sort of product in mind, some idea, do they just rent space at Hope in Maine? Is that how it works?
They rent space. I encourage them to visit makefoodyourbusiness.org. You want to remember that website. You can go there. You can learn about our offering of classes. We offer classes on cooking, nutrition, business planning, food safety certification.
Wow.
And then we have two monthly events that we highlight, one of which is called Cooking at Old School. It's one part cooking lesson, one part dinner club, and it serves as a fundraiser for Hope in Maine. And we also have our monthly Meet Your Maker Market, which is where the magic really unfolds. It's our version of a farmer's market. We do that once a month up until the summer, and then we have a weekly Sunday market, which is called Schoolyard Market.
Wow.
So not only do you see our makers in action, we bring in local artisans, local producers, and
you know, this is a great thing. A lot of people out there who love to cook all the time may not know where to turn to, or they have family coming over saying, man, you should do this on a bigger scale. They may not know where to turn to. Hope in Maine is the place to do it, and you'll be able to collaborate with other folks who know the business.
Absolutely, absolutely. And you get to navigate through those trials and tribulations. You know, you're not alone for the voyage, so to speak.
Right.
You have a really strong support staff built in there. And
Chef Bleu, I'm hitting you up on Sundays. If you could come over to the house.
Absolutely. You know, we can arrange that.
If you could come over to the house and just like put some of this together, it'd make things so much easier.
Indeed.
I don't
even
know where to begin. I think I'm going to try the lentils at first.
Please dig right in. Yeah, great.
I'm going to combine the lentils and a Brussels sprout. Right.
And I've been looking at these onions that look...
Oh, the cipollinis are just spectacular.
Crazy
and again, simple olive oil, roasted 425, you know, 30 minutes, and suddenly you have this abundance of flavors that, you know, you can't buy. I mean,
it's so good.
At least on the fast food rate.
I'm going to keep eating this. Make sure you get these recipes over at roadshow.com.